From an island so dangerous it killed hundreds of soldiers during the war, to an island steeped in mystery and murder, here are 10 of the creepiest things hidden on Forbidden Islands. Number 10. Dead Man's Island. Dead Man's Island in the United Kingdom is about as creepy as it gets. This forbidden island was once used as a burial ground for a prison colony and has recently been giving up some of its lost goods. Historians have been finding jaws full of teeth, broken skulls, and other chunks of human bones all throughout the island. What's even grislier is that some of the bones are so old that they've been swarmed by barnacles. It's actually pretty gross to look at, so don't go searching for the footage unless you're ready to see a real bone graveyard. At least 200 human remains were found in 2016 alone. Most of them belong to the men and boys who perished on board floating prisons that were moored in the area over 200 years ago. The people who died on these floating prisons were taken to the island and buried in shallow graves. But because of rising sea levels and constant erosion along the coastline, the bodies that were buried here have started to surface. Now there are loose pieces of coffins, random skeletons, and barnacle-ravaged bones littering the entire island. As of right now, visitors are banned from visiting the island. It's a protected wetland and important breeding site for birds. This is actually the reason why it's forbidden to go there, not because of the human bones. This site was deemed critical for the breeding and nesting of birds even before the bones began to appear. Number 9. Ross Island. Ross Island was once the site where convicts and political prisoners lived alongside wealthy British colonials. Today, it stands eerie and abandoned. The gruesome past of Ross Island can still be found to this day, shrouded in overgrown foliage and the knots of ficus trees. But what happened to this small island in the middle of the Pacific Ocean? After the Indian Mutiny of 1857, the British set up a penal colony to detain political prisoners. This was the beginning of Ross Island. It's the smallest of the 576 islands that form the Andaman and Nicobar archipelago. It was in such a place that the British colonists would be safe from attack and their Indian prisoners would have no chance of escape. The inmates were forced to build the island themselves, overseeing the construction of their own prisons as well as the luxurious habitations that the British officers called home. Then, convicts were sent to the island in hordes, most of them sick with disease. It was a pretty disgusting time. The island eventually shut down in 1937 after what some consider was the darkest chapter in the history of the British Empire. But there were still people left on the island. At least, there were until 1941 when a magnitude 8.1 earthquake occurred and killed over 3,000 people. And just 1 year later, the Japanese began heading in that direction, the British ran away, the island was pillaged of its material, and it hasn't really been occupied since. Today, it's administered by the Indian government and largely reclaimed by nature, though there are still hidden secrets if you have the stomach to poke around in the dirt. Number 8. Ramree Island. Ramree Island, located off the coast of Myanmar, is considered the most dangerous island in the world. It also hides a terrifying secret. It played a rather disturbing role in World War II with a handful of battles taking place on its shores. But 1945 was the most infamous year for the island. British soldiers were driving the Japanese back into the swampy mangrove forest away from the main part of the island. But what nobody knew at the time was that the mangrove forest was literally bursting with saltwater crocodiles. These crocodiles were completely impartial to the war. They didn't care who they ate. The crocodiles of Ramree Island can grow to be over 2,200 pounds, 998 kilograms, with lengths of up to 23 feet, 7 meters. According to National Geographic, saltwater crocodiles are the animals most likely to feast on a human, and that's exactly what they did to the Japanese soldiers. 1,000 soldiers fled into the mangrove forest. Only 500 of them escaped with their lives. Even the Guinness World Record has this marked down as the greatest number of fatalities in a single crocodile attack. Today, this is a forbidden zone. You are absolutely not allowed to go wandering into the deadly mangrove forest. And if you are hoping to find some fascinating World War II relics left behind by the deceased soldiers, good luck. You'd have to fight 2 dozen crocodiles just to get them. What would you do if you had to get access to this croc-infested territory? Let me know in the comments down below and be sure to like this video and subscribe if you haven't already. Number 7. Isola La Gaiola. Isola La Gaiola is a small, picturesque island with a dark and disturbing past. The island's located in the waters off the Gulf of Naples. The waters are emerald and clear, and depending on where you look, you may see submerged ruins hidden below the surface. There is a private villa on the island that to this day remains unoccupied. And believe it or not, the local Italians refuse to go anywhere near it as they fear the island is cursed. Talk of a curse didn't begin until the 1800s when a mysterious hermit known as Il Mago began living on the island. He was isolated from the community, squatting in a ramshackle hut until one day he just vanished and was never seen again. The next resident of Isola La Gaiola is the one who built the spacious villa that still dominates the island today. After he built it, he suffered financial ruin and his life turned to garbage. In 1911, a captain piloting his ship near the island, who had allegedly been thinking about buying it, crashed and drowned. Basically, misfortune has plagued those interested in the island up until the 1970s. Now the island is a protected marine area owned by the region. It's possible to visit, but you'd have to swim there from the shore. And considering how cursed this place is, you might never make it. Number 6. Vulcan Point Island. Vulcan Point is an island in the middle of a lake, with the lake being in the middle of a volcano, the volcano being in the middle of a slightly larger lake, which itself is in the center of a bigger island, and all of it inside of an archipelago found in the Pacific Ocean. Vulcan Point is in Lake Taal, the Philippines. It's a highly active volcano that has claimed thousands of innocent lives ever since it began erupting in 1977. It's considered the most active volcano in the region. But despite the danger, Vulcan Point is a hot destination for tourists, who enjoy hiking up the hill either on foot or on horseback. But here's how the island stacks up. At the very top of the Taal volcano, there's a caldera 1,000 feet, 305 meters above sea level. A caldera is basically the crater-shaped mouth of a volcano. This particular one is filled with water and considered to be the largest crater lake on the planet. Then in the center of this crater lake is a small island called Vulcan Point, which is actually a very small cone of the volcano. This place erupted most recently in January of 2020, killing 39 people and causing the lake to dry up. There are no longer tours being offered in the area, as it's become yet another dangerous and forbidden island. Number 5. Gruinard Island. Gruinard Island in Scotland has been contaminated for 50 years. It is one of the most secretive islands anywhere in the United Kingdom. Back in 1942, the British were developing an anthrax weapon to be used during World War II that would devastate the Germans. They were testing an extremely deadly strain of anthrax known as Volum 14-578. Bombs were filled with anthrax. They would then detonate in a cloud of toxic dust, which would drift down to kill anyone it came into contact with. But of course, the British couldn't really test the bomb on people. They instead tested the bomb on Gruinard Island, using sheep instead of humans. The army learned through their testing that they had the power to contaminate a German city so effectively that it could never be occupied again, or at least not for a few decades. Even all these years after the tests, Gruinard Island is uninhabitable and off-limits. The most recent case of anthrax on the island was in 2007 when a sheep got infected. The secrets on this island are better left hidden. Number 4. Palmyra Atoll. Palmyra Atoll is a place of intrigue and mystery. The island here was first visited by the Spanish privateer, the Esperanza, in 1816. The crew of the Esperanza had stolen the treasure during their occupation of Peru and loaded it onto their boat. There were at least 1.5 million Spanish gold coins along with a small hoard of Inca relics. But on their way back to Spain, the ship was attacked and boarded by pirates who stole the treasure. It was the pirates who then crashed the vessel on Palmyra Atoll and were forced to bury the majority of the treasure on the island. But there's more going on here than just lots of riches. There have been countless reports of people vanishing, of entire ships disappearing without a trace, and other spooky things going on in connection to the island. Nobody knows if it truly is haunted, but it seems like anyone unfortunate enough to spend any significant amount of time near the island ends up either very unlucky or very dead. And to date, nobody has managed to find that hidden treasure. Number 3. Povelia Island. Povelia Island is in a small lagoon near Venice. For centuries, it's been a horrifying place and a dumping ground for those with disease. In 1421, Povelia was used by people hiding from the barbaric invaders who were too lazy to go search the nearby islands. The escapees built a small community and lived on the island away from the mainland with their own laws and rules until around the 14th century, when the population dwindled and the island was abandoned. It was in 1348 that the bubonic plague arrived in nearby Venice. Povelia became an island quarantine colony. The plague killed one out of every three people in Italy. As you can imagine, the bodies stacked up quite quickly. Later on, Napoleon used the island to store gunpowder. In the 1800s, the island was used as an insane asylum full of crazy people. Then the island was used as a geriatric center until 1975. Today, the abandoned island is completely off-limits. But what's the hidden secret on the island, you ask? How about the remains of plague victims, a little bit of plague in the soil, and an alleged accumulation of dark forces powerful enough to scare any unwanted visitors right away? Number 2. North Sentinel Island. North Sentinel Island is without a doubt the most forbidden island in the world. We all learned about this strange, secluded place when the 26-year-old American blogger named John Allen Chow was killed by the island's inhabitants. John was an evangelical missionary. He wanted to convert the most isolated tribe in the world to Christianity. As a result, they shot him with an arrow. A lot happened in the aftermath. According to The Guardian, John's father blamed the American missionary community, saying that his son died from extreme Christianity. But what else happened is that the world had their sights on the indigenous group known as the Sentinelese, though we only named them this because they live on North Sentinel Island. To this day, nobody actually knows what the islanders call themselves. Where is this island? It's in the Andaman Island chain, about as far away from civilization as possible. These people are so secluded that they shoot arrows at planes when they fly by. There's somewhere between 80 and 150 people living on the island, but this is just an estimate. It could be as many as 500 or as few as 10. The people have been living there for God only knows how long. They live a very easy lifestyle and paddle around in their canoes harvesting crabs and fish. They really have a lifestyle that most had over 3,000 years ago. It's not clear what's going to be done with the Sentinelese. For now, it looks like the world is leaving them alone to their own devices. But sooner or later, the isolated tribe will probably be forced to join the rest of the world. Maybe they'll become their own community. What do you think? Number 1. Seaview Hospital. Seaview Hospital is one of those places you think would be fun to visit until you actually get there. This terrifying abandoned children's hospital was once the largest tuberculosis sanitarium in the US. It's full of used medical equipment, horrible memories, and the lingering ghosts of sick people. The hospital is on Staten Island and once included 37 buildings developed between 1904 and 1938. Nobody is supposed to go to this place. It's been shut down and forbidden since 1961, not only because of its disturbing past, but also because it's dangerous to prowl through the remnants of the hospital alone. There are even tunnels going underneath the hospital, probably leading down into hell. While this is definitely a hot spot with urban explorers, you're not allowed to go onto the property. And why would you want to? There were thousands of TB patients housed there. If you're lucky, you'll hear the screams of suffering children echoing through the halls at night. If you're unlucky, you'll see them. Thanks for watching. Which of these forbidden islands would you like to visit? Let me know in the comments down below, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already.